Hello everybody, welcome to Eurochannel. What is normal in urology? It seems that many users on YouTube are curious about normal functions of the body. In this video, I'm giving you the numbers for urine production and bladder function. So stay tuned to find out how many milliliters a normal bladder holds, how much you should drink, how often you should go to the bathroom, and lots more. My name is Stefan Buntrock, I'm a urologist with a specialization in sexual medicine. But don't worry, I'm a normal urologist. I did a normal residency and spent days and nights in the operating room. Which brings us right to the point of this video. What is normal when it comes to urology? Let's start at the top and look at urine first. Urine is produced in the kidneys and the volume is largely dependent upon how much we drink. Now, many people believe that it is important to drink enormous amounts of fluids, the more the better. Some think that only water counts and not coffee, tea or juice. Okay, this is all wrong. Yes, it's important to hydrate the body, but the amount needed is very much linked to a number of variables like body size. Surely a big man 6 or 7 feet tall, 240 pounds, needs more fluid than a small woman half the size. If the body loses increased amounts of fluid, like for example during sports activities or in hot climate or both, water intake has to be increased. So if I go for a round of golf on a hot sunny day during the summer, I easily drink 4 to 5 liters of water, which equals 1 gallon to 1.5 gallons. Not at once, of course, but over 4 to 5 hours. Which is crazy because on a normal day at the office, I hardly drink more than 1.5 to 2 liters, which is 1/2 gallon at max. A good rule of thumb is to look at the color of the urine. If it's dark as honey, you definitely need to drink more. If it's white like water, okay, now you've drunk too much. A light yellow color is perfect. And yes, every beverage counts, including tea and coffee. Did you know, by the way, that you can poison yourself from drinking too much water? It has happened in student initiation rituals when people were forced to drink water until the point of vomiting. What happens is that the body is just overloaded with water in a very short period of time, which the kidneys can't eliminate in a timely fashion. The blood gets diluted with a drop in sodium levels. This is called hyponatremia and can lead to serious consequences as the heart being disrupted in its rhythm, nausea, swelling of the brain with dizziness, confusions and cramps, coma, and even death. When going to the bathroom, how often is normal? Again, it depends on the amount of urine. Most adults feel a first desire to void when the bladder holds 150 to 250 milliliters, which is roughly 5 to 8 ounces. Maximal bladder capacity ranges between 350 and 550 milliliters, which equals 12 to 18 ounces. It is possible to train the bladder to hold much larger volumes, but it is not healthy to do so. Politicians and people who sit in meetings are the ones in danger here. You know, as soon as you leave the room, important decisions are taken without you. So everybody stays. Thing is, if you train your bladder to larger volumes, structural changes might occur, resulting in residual urine. This means that you are unable to empty your bladder completely. Residual urine is potentially a bad thing, as it leads to repeating urinary tract infections and stone formation, among others. Furthermore, unphysiological urination habits like not taking enough time, pressing, hovering over the toilet seat may have a negative impact on pelvic floor function, resulting in pelvic pain syndromes, urgency, and all kinds of symptoms many doctors are unable to explain. So in order to keep your bladder happy, try to drink enough fluids that it can do its job, which is collecting urine and emptying. In other words, stretching and contracting. Go when you have to. Take your time, and it is perfectly normal to empty the bladder 6 to 8 times during the day. At night, it depends. If you drink lots of fluid at bedtime, you will have to get up at night. Young people don't have to go at night, which is due to a hormone that is released from the brain during sleep, which downregulates kidney activity while sleeping. Problem is, when we get older, also the bladder gets older and the excretion of antidiuretic hormone gets less at the same time. So around the age of 60, it is absolutely normal to get up once at night. Okay, let's talk about Qmax. Qmax is the peak amount of urine during urination and is expressed by milliliters per second. When the bladder is filled with 150 milliliters or 5 ounces, Qmax in men is 20 to 30 milliliters per second and in women 20 to 35 milliliters per second. These are average numbers. I've had patients who exceeded these numbers by far. How is it measured? Urologists usually have a device, a flow meter, which is a big funnel linked to a computer which calculates these numbers. So the patients simply urinate into this funnel, the urine gets collected, and I get all these numbers instantly calculated. I've tried to find out how far a man would be able to urinate while standing with a Qmax of 30 milliliters per second, but couldn't find anything. I'm not a master of physics, so I was unable to do the calculation myself. If you're interested, calculate with a urethral diameter of 0.3 inches, urethral length of 9 inches, and a pressure of 9,300 pascal. Post your results in the comments. My guess is the results will come close to 6 feet. Please tell me if you're interested in more normal urology stuff. Two of my first posts were about normal penile length. So go ahead and check them out. See you soon. Bye bye.